Cecilia, and I hope you all are having a wonderful day. Today, I would like to talk about films. And I am inspired by the wonderful Angelica. She made a video about her favorite films a couple of days ago. And it was great. And I will, of course, link it in the info box. And yeah, I wanted to talk about some of my favorite films as well. Because I think that films are almost equally important to me as books. I like storytelling in all kind of formats. And this was pretty hard because I have a lot of a lot of movies that I considered favorites, but I have narrowed it down to 6 films. And some of them have similar themes to some of my favorite books, and that was quite neat to see. And yeah, it's quite an eclectic pile. I do have 2 disclaimers, or 1 disclaimer, and that is that even though David Lynch is one of my favorites, he is not on this list, mainly because I had a very hard time picking a film. So, yeah, he was left out. But let's get started with the films. The first film is Blade Runner by Ridley Scott. This is a neo-noir science fiction film from 1982, and it sets in the future. The future is 2019. And in this world, there has been created these creatures called the replicants. And they are supposed to be like servants for the people. They are not supposed to have free will. And if they are not doing as they are told, they will be determined. The main character is Harrison Ford, or played by Harrison Ford. And he is a replicant hunter. And he is on the hunt after a group of replicants that had run away. And we are following him while he's meeting a woman he falls in love with, and he also meets the group leader of the replicants. And I love the atmosphere in this film. It's so dark and gloomy, yet beautiful. And I really enjoy like the more philosophical aspect of it. What is a human? What makes us human? And you can see that the replicants also has feelings, they have thoughts, and they have a will that they want to have free will. And in many ways, the group of replicants are more human or human-like than the people in this film. And yeah, I really love it. And also, this is a movie that I can watch again and again, and I will find something new, and I will also rediscover things. So yeah, it's such a wonderful, wonderful movie. Another movie is Autumn Sonata by Ingmar Bergman. And this is about a very troubled relationship between a mother and a daughter. The mother is this famous classical musician, and she has sacrificed her role as a mother to become this musician. Her daughter, who has grown up, has chosen a different path. She herself is pretty successful. She can play the piano. She has written books, but she also is married, and she has had a kid that has died. And they haven't seen each other for many years. And then they meet for like one day and one night. And they talk, and wounds from the past opens. And it's a big confrontation. And for me, this has a lot to do with a mother that doesn't see her daughter for who she really is, but she tries to fit her into the image she herself has of her daughter. And that is something you can see very well in one of my favorite scenes in that movie. The daughter and the mother are sitting next to the piano, and the daughter is playing this classical piece, and then the mother takes over and she plays it the way that she thinks is the correct way to play it, and she doesn't acknowledge that her daughter can play. And it's such a mellow and quiet but yet dramatic story, and it really tugged all my heartstrings, and it is my personal favorite of Ingmar Bergman. Then I have my favorite horror movie, and that is Suspiria by Dario Argento. And this is set in Germany at a ballet school, and we are following this American young woman who is attending the school. And when she gets there, a lot of mysterious things starts to happen. There are a lot of murders, and she starts to like hallucinate, and she gets this feeling that there is something sinister hiding in the ballet school, and that the teachers are hiding something. And this is such a perfect production, I think. I love the way Argento is using the colors. There's a lot of like vivid bright red and black, and it makes the movie more like intense. The music is superb. It is by the Goblins. They have the soundtrack, and I have no idea how this movie would be if we didn't have this soundtrack, because it's so integrated in the movie and it's such a big part of the movie and the story, and it's brilliant. And also, it's a really scary movie, it's a horror, but the killings are of such an aesthetic, and like, yes, it's aesthetic, it's very aesthetically to look at, even though it's horrendous. And in the beginning, so I don't think this is a spoiler, you see someone get stabbed in the heart, and you can see the heart is like in this open rib cage, and you can see the heart pounding, and then this knife is like stabbing it. And yes, it's like so macabre, but at the same time, it looks really beautiful. So, Suspiria is a fantastic, fantastic movie. And even though I was a bit hesitant when they announced the remake, I really enjoyed that as well, but it is completely different. Then I have a Swedish movie by Pernille August. It's called Beyond. And this is about a woman who lives in Stockholm with her family. She has a husband and two daughters. And she lives this perfectly normal life. And then she gets a phone call from a hospital in her hometown, and her mother has been like hospitalized and is terminally ill. So she has to go back to her hometown, and she hasn't been there for many, many years. And going back brings back memories from her childhood in the 70s that were filled with abuse and alcoholism, and that makes all the, like, her defenses on all that she has built around herself during the years to crackle. And yeah, so for me, this is a movie about how you are protecting yourself against trauma and what happens when your defenses are being pushed so you can't defend yourself anymore. And it's a really, really painful experience, but at the same time, very powerful, and I loved it. Then I have a completely different film, and that is Moulin Rouge by Baz Luhrmann. And this is such an explosion of a movie. It is filled with colors and music, and the scenery is so lush and beautiful, and it's like everything. And the story itself has everything. It has love and passion and lust and death and jealousy and intrigue. And it's like, it has everything. And I love the way Luhrman is using the music. I love the dance scenes. And the story overall is wonderful. And my favorite scene is the tango scene. The tango de Roxanne. It gives me goosebumps every time. And then I have one more. And no. Yes, I have one more. The last film that I will talk about is a Korean movie called Binyip here in Norway. I do think the English title is Three Iron, and it's by Ki Duk Kim, and it's from 2004. And this is a romantic mystery sort of film. And it's about this young man who is entering empty houses and lives in houses where the owners are on vacation. And he doesn't do anything criminal. He's fixing the house and just living there. And one day he enters the wrong house. The house is not empty. But he has this ability to almost be invisible, so no one notices him. But he witnesses that the man in the house is abusing his wife. And he wants to save her, so he takes her with him. And then this really strange yet beautiful love affair starts. And what makes this movie stand out is that there is almost no dialogue at all. It's just like facial expressions and using their bodies. And I thought it was such a interesting and beautiful experience. So yeah, that was five of my favorite films. And please let me know in the comments what your favorite films are. Maybe we have some in common, or maybe you have some recommendations to me. I do love to get some recommendations. And thank you so, so much for watching. And until next time, ha det!